Hello, everyone. Welcome to the session on Amazon DocumentDB 5.0 and its new features. I'm Karthik Tota, and I'm a DocumentDB Specialist Solution Architect at AWS. In this talk, I'll give a brief overview of Amazon DocumentDB and the new features included in this release. Then I'll talk about and demonstrate client-side field-level encryption and the new aggregation operators, which are a couple of recent additions, so you know when and how to utilize them. Finally, I wrap up this talk by providing you with the resources to get you started. But first, what is Amazon DocumentDB? At its core, Amazon DocumentDB is designed to store, index, and query rich, complex JSON document with high availability and scalability. You can retrieve documents based on nested field values, join data across collections, and perform aggregation queries. So if you need schema flexibility and ability to index and query rich structured and semi-structured documents, Amazon DocumentDB is a great choice. Amazon DocumentDB clusters provide 4 nines of availability with highly durable storage, which maintains 6 copies of your data in 3 availability zones in an AWS region. Amazon DocumentDB instance-based clusters can handle tens of thousands of write operations per second and millions of read operations per second with one primary and 15 replica instances and support up to 128 TB of data. While Amazon DocumentDB Elastic clusters with 32 shards can handle workloads requiring petabytes of storage and millions of read and write operations per second. Amazon DocumentDB architecture lets you to scale your database in, out, up or down in minutes, irrespective of the data size. AWS manages the underlying hardware, operating system, and database softwares, and takes care of maintenance, patching, and failovers, freeing you from doing undifferentiated heavy lifting of managing your database infrastructure. Amazon DocumentDB supports hundreds of MongoDB operators and aggregation stages, and provide wide protocol compatibility with MongoDB API, making it easy for you to use your existing MongoDB compatible applications, frameworks, drivers, and tools with little or no code change to work with DocumentDB. Amazon DocumentDB 5.0 was released in March 2023 with multiple new features and enhanced functionality. It added support for client-side field-level encryption, which allows you to selectively encrypt the data in application without needing to develop any libraries. We have increased the volume storage limit to 128 TB from the previous limit of 64 TB. This increase is applicable to all Amazon DocumentDB clusters, including 3.6 and 4.0 clusters, as well as Elastic clusters. Now, each shard in Amazon DocumentDB Elastic clusters will have a maximum storage capacity of 128 TB. You pay only for the storage and I/O that you consume, and you don't need to provision these resources in advance. For existing cluster, the storage limit increase get applied automatically and requires no action from your side. With this release, you now get added support for MongoDB 5.0 drivers, support for 2 new aggregation operators, date add and date subtract. Amazon DocumentDB 5.0 now supports index scanning with $LM match operator in the first nesting level, improving the read performance of the queries using $LM match. Client-side field-level encryption. With client-side field-level encryption, sensitive data such as personally identifiable information or PII data can be encrypted in application before being sent to Amazon DocumentDB for storage. Client-side field-level encryption uses AWS key management service keys to encrypt your data. As the data is encrypted at application level, even the administrators cannot read the actual data without the data keys. The initial configuration of client-side field-level encryption is a 4-step process. First, we need to create a customer key using the AWS KMS. Next, we create an IAM policy that can use the key and associate with the application user. You can also use IAM roles in place of IAM user. And using the customer key created in the first step, we would generate the data encryption key. Using the data encryption key, we'll selectively encrypt the data in application. Let's see client-side field-level encryption in action in the demo. In this demo, I'll be using a Python program. I'll show you how to use client-side field encryption to encrypt data in application. Before moving on to the Python script, let us set up the prerequisites needed to run it. To start, I need an Amazon DocumentDB cluster and an IAM user. I'm using my existing demo CSFLE DocumentDB cluster and an IAM user. This is my demo CSFLE DocumentDB cluster. And here is my demo app user, IAM user. And I'm also using Secrets Manager to store my database credentials. Using AWS Secrets Manager, we can avoid hard coding of credentials in the application. As I said before, the first step is to create customer key. So let's navigate to KMS from the AWS console and create the customer key. And I choose the defaults. I'll be using the same key to encrypt and decrypt, and I choose next. And I provide some name for my key. And provide some optional description. And choose next. And choose an administrator for the key. And review the key settings and click on finish. Now my CSFLE demo key is ready for use. Now we have KMS key. Now next step is to let IAM demo app user to use this key. I go back to my IAM console and I create an inline policy to add permissions. Create inline policy. And I choose JSON. And as I'm using Secrets Manager, I'm adding that into my policy for the user to be able to read the secrets. And I use my KMS key to provide the access. Review policy. Give a policy name. And now that I have my KMS key setup and the user policy setup, now I move on to Python program. I'll be using the AWS Cloud 9 to build and run this script. I built the Python script by following the steps mentioned in the blog on the CSFLE or the client-side field-level encryption in the DocumentDB. For easy reference, I added the blog details to the reference section of this talk. So I move back to my script. We need to set a few attributes like KMS key, secrets, and the region. So I'll be using the KMS. I have set up the remaining things, and now I'll be using the KMS key I created. And I save it. And this script is having three functions. One is the first function, getSecret, is to retrieve the credentials. The second function would be generating you a data key. And the third function, readWrite, would be using the data key and insert the data in your database. And before I execute, let me log into the database and show you it is empty. So there is no data in the database. Now I will execute this demo CSFLE program. Here, and as soon as I execute, I would be provided with the options whether to generate keys or perform read-write operation. So I don't have the keys ready. So the immediate next step is to generate the keys. And now my key is generated. Let's go back to the database and see how it looks. So now I have ENCR namespace created. Let me show you the key. So this is the key created here. And now we have the key got created. The next step is to perform a read-write operation. I re-execute the same script, and I now choose perform read-write. Now this data is inserted. So what I'm inserting, an encrypted date of birth, encrypted email, and unencrypted data favorites, friends, and gamer tag. So this is the data how you see in the database at the encrypted one, and this is the decrypted document. So this is the output of our script. Let's go back to our database. So I have the use GamesDB now, and I inserted the data in the users collection in the GamesDB database. So this is how the data looks like. You have the gamer tag, an encrypted email, an encrypted date of birth, and you have unencrypted favorite friends. So this is a quick demo of how to use client-side field-level encryption. Let's go back to the presentation. To demonstrate the aggregation operators, I would be inserting sample data containing the order information. So I'll go back to my Cloud9. And this order data is having the information for order date, pay date, warranty expiry date, and order location. And we don't have manufacturing date, and we don't have delivery date. What we know is my delivery date would be 5 days after the order date. So I'll add 5 days to the order date using the new date add operator and generate a delivery date. I use date add operator, and I provided order date as input to the date add operator, and the unit I mentioned as days. So what I'm seeing here is add 5 days to my order date and give me the delivery date. This is what happened. So my delivery date is calculated by adding 5 days to my order date. Now let me I don't have manufacturing date. Now I know my manufacturing date would be 6 months earlier to my expiry date. I only have the warranty expiry date. So I subtract 6 months from my warranty expiry date to get my manufacturing date. So here I am passing warranty expiry date and a unit as month and the 6 days, amount as 6 for 6 months. So based on this query, my manufacturing date is calculated based on by subtracting 6 months from the warranty expiry date. And this is a quick demo on new aggregation operators. Let's move back to the presentation. If you haven't used Amazon DocumentDB in your AWS account, then you can use for 1 month free trial where you get 750 hours of T3 medium instance, 5 GB storage, and 30 million IOs and 5 GB backup for 30 days. And if you're already using Amazon DocumentDB and want to get started with client-side field-level encryption or other features on Amazon DocumentDB, here are some resources that could help you. With that, I would like to thank you for joining the session today.